bring in the Speaker of the House, Kevin McCarthy, on these fast-moving developments. They've been good, you said, the gang of informing the Gang of Eight about what's going on. Where is Vladimir Putin, and what do you think is next?
Well, regardless of what happened here, Putin is much weaker. And Putin seems like a different person, but I've always believed Putin to be like a mafia boss, and you're watching it today. Putin would have never let Prigozhin get this far or continue. I mean, Prigozhin, this wasn't a secret. He was publicly criticizing Putin, criticizing the military.
Putin, but he would not even mention Putin's name.
Yeah, but he said the leadership. And remember what he put out just a couple days ago. The whole entrance into Ukraine was a lie and lying to the people. And you watched the people rise up and support Prigozhin. And for his ability to get that close to Moscow without the Air Force taking him out, that's got to be scary.
What does it say to you that Vladimir Putin is in hiding now? He's not coming out, but contrast that to Zelensky. He was out in the streets. He's like, come and get me.
I know,
but leaving my people.
You know, Biden saying, I'm sending you a helicopter to get you out to Zelensky says, no, send me weapons.
Yeah.
And Putin hides. I mean, Putin has been doing this he's isolating himself. He's slow to make decisions. He's just not the same when you watch him. And you watch that. Russia is not a constitutional government. I mean, it is really just an illegal form.
Collection of warlords.
Yeah. It's the oligarchs and others paying for it, and the corruption, and they're finding it in their own military, the corruption they spent on it. They don't have the military weapons they need, and it was a mistake to go in Ukraine. What really needs to happen here is President Xi of China needs to back away from any support to Russia. That should be a clear sign to him, too, and change.
But he's not.
He's not. But
he might look at this,
but
though,
and
say Putin's looks
the world leader should pressure.
Yeah.
President Xi.
The mob boss, as you described him.
They are.
Not as tough as he was just a
week
ago.
No.
Mr. Speaker, I want you to watch Ted Cruz, who works across the building from you. He has a podcast, and here's what he had to say over the weekend regarding Hunter Biden and his use of the WhatsApp app. Watch.
This WhatsApp is direct evidence of Joe Biden abusing his government power to enrich his son and assuming 10% for the big guy to enrich himself. Remember, this WhatsApp says, we want to know. This is not me, Hunter, just sort of mooching off my dad. This WhatsApp directly ties Joe Biden to the millions of dollars coming from communist China. It is possible Hunter Biden was lying. It's possible Joe Biden wasn't next to him. It's possible Joe Biden was not going to inflict official damage on the Chinese if they didn't pay him and his son millions of dollars. That's possible. But you know what? We don't know if it's true or not. Why? Because according to the whistleblower, they didn't investigate and they were prohibited from investigating.
Right. And so, Mr. Speaker, the WhatsApp thing essentially said, hey, this is me. It's Hunter Biden. I'm sitting here with my dad, and you better pay us as quickly as possible. Also kind of sounding like a mob boss.
Correct.
But what he's calling for, what the senator's calling for, is for essentially the wheels start moving toward an impeachment of Joe Biden. Impeachments start in your department.
Yeah, but I'm happy Ted is catching up to what we've been doing since we took power. I mean, the whole reason you have the WhatsApp message is because the work the House Republicans have been doing, not just in Comer, not just in Jordan, but this was in Ways and Means under Jason Smith. These are IRS long-term workers who've been through it and watched the abuse of power of how Hunter Biden was treated. I mean, they even waited to get the 6-year statute of limitation off where they Burisma money he didn't get charged for, some of the highest prosecution. They want to have a special counsel, and now we're seeing that the DOJ, the Attorney General declined that, even though he's saying something different. So we have requested by July 6th Weiss to come in to answer these questions, because the IRS whistleblowers took copious notes during those meetings, come back with the date, the six people in it. And he took these notes, but he emailed everybody back, this is what was said during the meeting.
So will you have both there? Will you have Weiss there and Shapley there, who came forward, the IRS whistleblower?
The thing people don't realize is every single day we're bringing people in. This is why you're getting
maybe
this information.
Maybe not together.
This is why you have the bank statements now. This is why you know about the 1023. This is why you know about WhatsApp. We're continuing to do our information much different than anybody else. I wish none of this would ever happen or go forward with somebody in elected office.
Right.
But now we found the president has lied to us. He said they never dealt with anything in China. Now we The whistleblower says that he was in a meeting with a Chinese company as the vice president. We now know that they got millions of dollars. It came through shell companies. The 1023 that was warned to the FBI, that was never given to the IRS whistleblowers that was investigating Hunter Biden. And it would have put good information.
Brian was asking this question last week. Why?
Or does it just look fishy?
Well, it's more than looking fishy. The family created companies when he was a VP. You get 1023 saying people had to pay them to get influence. We now see foreign governments have paid. If you create a company, why wouldn't you have an office? Why wouldn't you create something? Why do you get paid by shell companies and forward it to other shell companies, then go down to pay family members that never work into it? None of it smells right. None of it is right. They talk about the big guy, but I believe firmly we have to have a constitutional...
Please join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the MCAD TV family. Please like and share MCAD TV. We love you all. Please support MCAD TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.